r/nuclear revenge. First story. Rule hash 1, don't cheat on me. I've been reading the posts here for a couple weeks and think it's time I contributed one of my own. Obvious throwaway account. Didn't want to wait for the 7-day rule slash TL. Doctor at the bottom. Yada yada yada. In 2008, I met this amazingly awesome girl in school. Let's call her CR. I was 21 and she was just about to turn 19, and we both knew what love was for the first time in our lives. We were both going to a community college, me for theater design and her for education. We lived about half an hour apart, but that was nothing more than a minor inconvenience, because we spent every free moment between classes together. Come to think of it, that slight distance was actually pretty nice, because being home at least forced us to focus on homework, and taking care of ourselves, and visiting each other at home was that much more special. CR graduated with her associates in 2009. And moved away to a state school to finish up her degree in early childhood special education. Like before, the distance was not a concern because it was a short train ride away and I'd spend one or two weekends a month down there with her. I proposed to her on Valentine's Day 2010. School wasn't really my thing and I ended up enlisting in the USAF that following May and got moved halfway across the country to a place neither of us had ever imagined visiting. However, like before, we wouldn't let distance get in our way. Now it should be noted that her mom did not like me. I still don't know why, but she was always the loudest, rudest, most annoying and disrespectful cunt bag I've ever met. She was from the city and she married into a family of farmers that owned the land since the 1870s, so that may explain part of her malice. From here on, evil bitches ebb. Another thing to know is that I have a great memory, and this will be important later on in the story. Anyway, back to the military. I had a 2-week break between my training and leaving for my first and only duty station, which just happened to be over Christmas and New Year's. Even though we were engaged, we hadn't really put any consideration into actually getting married. She wanted something small with her family and cousins, and I was completely okay with going to a courthouse and getting it over with. I don't want to sound like I was trying to pressure her into that, but the way I saw it, I would be living in barracks in a few weeks, and being married would get me a full monthly housing allowance which I would save to have a wedding ceremony when we had time in another year or two. Basically, get married now, don't tell anyone, because they would all get hella upset for not being involved, and have a fake wedding ceremony that would include both of our families and friends. It turns out that, because I was living in barracks, I wasn't allowed to collect the housing allowance, and when, 6 months later, they realized I was actually married, kicked me out, and made me get a house on base. Either way, we didn't get married when I was home on leave and took an Amtrak train out west. I highly recommend traveling cross country by train if you have the time. The first time we were able to see each other after that was during her spring break, which was the first part of March. CR and I finally eloped in a courthouse and spent the next few days glued to each other penis and vagina style like every young married couple should. I flew back home for a couple weeks in June, and this is when things started to unravel. Easter Seals, for those who don't know, runs summer camps for special needs kids, and my new wife volunteered to be a counselor for the last 7 weeks of the summer. The last time I saw her that summer was just after her June birthday, when I dropped her off at camp. The rest of the summer was hit or miss getting in touch with her, since she was on the clock 24 hours a day for 5 days a week, and I completely understood her commitment to those kids. When she was back in school the following fall, she became increasingly distant, making excuses about how her phone would be randomly dead at oddly predictable times every week. She flew out to spend Christmas with me in our new house, technically a shitty, mostly empty duplex, and things felt amazing, like they had been. After that, however, she went back to being super reclusive, like she was the previous semester. Fast forward to May 2012. I took a whole month of leave to fly home for her graduation and to help move her in with me. I barely recognized her. Every bit of CR's communication with me was forced, and so funny that I should have known what was really happening all along. She had set up what she called mock interviews with a couple grade schools near her hometown, and I actually believed that she was doing it just to get experience interviewing. What an idiot. When I finally started to catch on to how serious she was about getting a job in our home state, she broke down crying and made it seem like I was forcing her to choose between me and her career, and of course I wanted to put our marriage before anything else. Obviously I returned to base without her. A couple weeks later I pressured her into telling me what the hell was going on. She fell in love with one of her fellow camp counselors and let the affair go on for about 9 months, with claims that she was going to tell me, but didn't know when. The usual too guilty to tie your own shoes bullshit, and she honestly expected me to walk away from our relationship right then and there. No. I fought tooth and nail to hold us together for 2 months before filing the divorce. I'm skipping a bunch of sappy details here, but the divorce was filed late August and became final that December, mandatory 90-day waiting period in my state. The pain I suffered in that one-sided relationship is something I would never wish on anybody, unless that truly deserved it. Apparently, Eb whispered all kinds of lies to her about how I joined the military to get away from her, and actually had the gall to blame me for all the crying and misery her oldest child was going through. My soon-to-be ex never admitted who was blaming me for everything, but I was really close to her dad and siblings, so I can't imagine that they would ever suspect me, but Eb was so manipulative that by Halloween they had all turned against me. At that point I had it. I was near suicidal and my anxiety attacks were hitting basically every day. I was miserable, tired of being lied to, tired of the slander, tired of being the bad guy when I was the one who was attacked here. It started with sending texts to her brothers and sister saying, "Hey, I'm actually your brother-in-law. Nice to know that we don't keep secrets, right?" CR exploded, but that was just the beginning. I wrote a 3,000 word letter explaining in every detail I could recall exactly what happened, the fact that we were married, including copies of the marriage license and certificate, our plans for the future, and how I was the only one living up to our expectations, where she met the guy she was fucking behind my back, his name, address, phone number, camp counselor name, so CR would have a harder time refuting it, and a bunch of other information that she made me keep secret from them. I sent copies to everyone in her extended family, well, everyone I had an address for, her roommates, the summer camp she worked at, close professors she had brought up in old conversations, and the principal of the school she ended up working at. Calling the fallout catastrophic is an understatement. Her super devout Catholic family basically disowned her, her reputation at her former school was shattered, and the tension at her new job was apparently high enough that CR was forced to resign from her position before Christmas break started. Getting those secrets off my chest was the most cathartic moment of my life. TL, Dr. My ex-wife and I got married in secret, but never lived together. She cheated on me for almost a year, and I got her disowned by her family and forced out of her first teaching job by telling everyone she was close to every dirty little secret I could remember. Edit, added a single word. Second story. So, you like hurting others? Enjoy being jumped by a mob of kids in front of us. Your mother gets some karma too. This took place maybe 2 to 3 years ago. TL, doctor at the bottom. I was volunteering for a camp, BCS. I really needed to go out some more, and either we, a camp would be nice. Me, F1 and F2, F1 and F2 were actual members of the camp, were leaders for a group of 30 children. All of them were cool, always listening to us, and following the rules. All, except one, OFC. This little cunt, LC in the story, was a demon spawn. He bit, pulled hair, threw stuff, beat, choke, push other children. Once, he bit F2 hard, but we managed to get LC off him. The mother, cunt's mother, centimeters, was a bitch. She always blamed the victims, threatened to sue us if LC was kicked out, and also encouraged LC's behavior. You couldn't talk sense into her. She always said that she had connections to the police, she will get anyone arrested, said some racial stuff to others, and kept saying he's just playing whenever we told her about LC. This went on and on for about a week, until all other children had enough. They decided to just jump and make him endure several minutes of beating next time we went hiking. Only, some girls and boys came to us and told us the plan, snitches, and left. Me, F1, F2 look at each other and decided to let them do it. We were sick of him. So, next day, while we were hiking, LC began hitting another child. While me and F1 went ahead to scout the road, the other children jumped, and I mean jumped, LC. The cunt endured 10 minutes of hair pulling, kicks, punches, and children biting him. When we got back, the mob stopped. LC looked at us like he has seen God. But I watched as all color drained from his face as me F1 and F2 gave a wink and just sat by. Then, with smiles on their faces, the mob resumed its punishment. By the end of it, LC looked like a roadkill, but still alive. When we got back, Centimeter screamed bloody murder when she saw LC. She started accusing us and the children of assault when I got in her face and whispered they were just playing. She tried to hit me, but I dodged and slapped her to the ground. THX dad for these reflexes, telling her that she and LC are banned from the camp. She left in a hurry, with a crying LC behind her. Some days later, a police car arrived, due to a call about children abuse and assault. The policeman talked to the children, us and the other parents, and left, as they saw the children happy and everything alright. She tried calling the police 4 more times, before being arrested for false accusations. The parents didn't believe her, when she said their children did this, as she lied before. We just told them he tripped, and fell down a hill. BCS he didn't follow the rules. And they fucking bought it. The children who informed us of the plan kept quiet, happy with the result. In short, TL. Doctor, kid is a cunt. Beats children. Children form a mob and jump him. We see it, and let it happen. Cunt's mother calls the police 5 times and is arrested. Other children's parents believe us, when we say he fell down a hill. And that's it, the end. Notes, you can say that we should stop the mob, but we are SHT human beings, and not morally superior. We wanted revenge as well.